Hello and welcome to Keep Creating, a show about the wonderful world of paper crafting. Have you ever wanted to make your own greeting cards? Have you wondered about what scrapbooking is all about? Do you already craft and want to learn some new technique to help improve what you're doing? Well, then you've tuned into the right program. Keep Creating is the place to ask those crafty questions, because our aim is to provide answers. Today we're going to talk to Kim Parkinson, the owner of Kept Creations, a longtime Whitman resident whose shop, Kept Creations, is located right here on South Ave in downtown Whitman.
So, I just moved in with this family, and it's embarrassing. The little one, he likes to go outside and crawl around in the giant litter box. I don't know what he's doing. I mean, I was born and I knew how to use the litter box. Look at that. That's disgusting. Oh, poop already. You're making me nervous. Oh, okay, I can't look at this anymore. I really hope he grows out of this, for his sake.
Welcome back. We're going to talk now to Kim Parkinson, the owner of Kept Creations. We'll find out a little bit about her and how she happened to get started in this business. Kim.
Hi.
It's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
So you are a local girl, I understand.
I am.
Where did you start out?
I grew up in Holbrook, Mass., so right down the street, really. I went to Holbrook High School. And I then from there, I went to Newberry College on a full scholarship. I got a scholarship for hotel restaurant management and have an associate's degree in hotel restaurant management, which actually, believe it or not, even though you wouldn't think so, it helps tremendously in this field. It's basically a hospitality degree. And
You gotta be hospitable in retail.
Exactly, you have to be. So it's actually, I learn a lot from, I pull back from my degree a lot. Once I graduated from there, I actually, let's see, what did I do? after I graduated college, I went to work at Nellie Mae, which was a student loan company. And I got married, and after we got married, we moved here to Whitman in 1999, and we've been here ever since. My first son was born in 2001, my second in 2003, and I was a stay-at-home mom for most of that time. Even when I was teaching at the Scrapbook Cupboard in East Bridgewater, I really was mostly a stay-at-home mom. This is my first full-time job since 2000.
And how did you get involved in crafting?
I actually started because I had two small boys, and I was a scrapbooker, just like everybody else at the time. We took our pictures and we put them to paper and embellished them with different dyes and different borders and wrote down different notes and just started scrapbooking.
And where did you go from there?
Well, once I started that, I had asked the store owner over at the Bridgewater store, East Bridgewater store, if she needed any teachers, any instructors. And she happened to like my work and told me that she'd be happy to have me come in. So I just started teaching a couple of classes over there. And as the trends of anything evolve, so doesn't the trends of paper crafting. So what we've done is she started with scrapbooking and then she moved to more stamping and more what they call mixed media. And I just gravitated more towards those than I did to the scrapbooking. So I kind of gave up my scrapbooks and kind of moved more into a paper crafting field. I do a little bit of everything now.
Well, what kinds of things are people doing in the paper crafting field these days?
Well, right now, the most popular thing, I think, is art journaling. Most people have probably, if they are a paper crafter, they've heard of art journaling. And basically, you take some paint, some ink, some stamps. You take all sorts of different types of media and you put it onto paper. And the other thing you do is you write your thoughts. A lot of people have very little bit of time to craft. So having that one piece of paper done in a book that might be private, kind of like an embellished diary. And I think nowadays people need that creative outlet, but the place to write something nice, something about their day or what they're feeling at the moment. And so that's the most popular one right now, is art journaling.
Well, what other kinds of things have we got going?
Well, here we also do altered arts, where we take and we upcycle things. We have, we've done toilet paper rolls, we've done old used paint brushes, pine cones, cigar boxes, and basically we take them and we alter them. We decorate them with paper and ink and buttons and little doodads and gears and whatever you can find, and kind of put it onto it, and you just do something different with it. So you're no longer throwing it away. You're making it something beautiful and something that you want to display, or something usable even. We've also got a large group of ladies that love stamping. Stamping is a great opportunity for greeting cards, or even just if you were to scrapbook, you could actually stamp right into that, into a memory journal. We have a large array of die cuts, and die cuts give a lot of versatility because it looks exactly the same every time you cut it out. So it makes it nice. People like to use them. Different color papers, you can add a little ink to it, you can leave it as it is, and they just love to be able to have something tangible after they're done.
Well, how did you get involved in working in the retail end of things in crafting?
The retail end of it, well, it's a little bit of a just fortune, I guess. The woman on Route 18 was closing her store, and she had actually offered me the store, and I had said, no way, there's no way I'm opening my own store, that's way too much work. But my husband and I was teaching out of my house and out of the community center on top of, there's a little community center above Stop and Shop, and that I was teaching there, and I had a little bit of a store in my house, and my husband said, forget about this, this is way too cramped, no way. So we had actually talked to our tax guy one day, and we were just mentioning that this might be something we'd like to do. My husband got laid off from his job, and so it was a perfect opportunity for the two of us to put our heads together and to get a business plan off the ground. This whole entire place was actually Patrick's idea, not quite mine. I kind of went along with it, and I love it, but it was his idea to begin with.
And how did you happen to choose on Whitman Center?
Location, location, location. I live half a mile away. It makes it really super nice. I have two boys that are in the school system here in Whitman. One is 10 and one's 12, and they can walk here if they need to. If they need me, they can walk here. If I need to get home, it only takes me 2 minutes to get here. That was most important for me. I did want something on a main route, and I wanted something with enough space for a classroom setting. So this is what a couple of choices that we had, and this is the one that I thought was the most bright and airy and got great parking out back too.
How's the business climate here in Whitman Center?
It's actually up and coming. We actually have a lot of walk-in traffic. We have a lot of people that are interested in knowing what we do here, and they're very, very susceptible. They've welcomed me to the area for this type of store. We've had a lot of people come in and just be very, very happy that we're here.
You mentioned that you have classes here. How many classes do you do? What kinds of things do the classes entail?
Well, we have 8 teachers on staff here. They are anywhere from elegant stamping and crafting to mixed media, more what I would call grungy, or it almost has like a shabby chic look to it. We also have teachers that do delicate things like quilling, and we also have teachers that do just fun everyday greeting cards. So we have eight girls that come in, and they all teach something different. Our clients are vast. We have quite a bit of people that like what we do here. And we have a class pretty much every night, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. And sometimes we have two classes on Saturday and a class on Sunday. We do try to hold a kids class once a month, and we do stuff like basic stamping, painting, just some basic things for the kids to try out.
Okay, well, thanks a lot, Kim. That's all we have for now. Come back in just a minute and we'll be taking a little tour of the store so you can see what's available here for those who love the crafting world.
Human for a while and you get to know a few things. Like, I know she's actually not a morning person. I know she does strange tricks for no treats. I know that water makes her howl like crazy. I even know how the floor stays so clean. She's quick. But the one thing I will never for the life of me know is how she gets so tiny and inside that box. Natalie, how do you get so tiny?
We're back and taking a tour of Kept Creations. Kim, this is the kids' corner. What kind of stuff do we have here for kids to do crafts with?
We have all sorts of different types of things, and we try to keep up with the trends of what's going on with kids. We don't have a huge kids' corner, but it's willing to grow as the needs of the community allows. Right now, what I have been told is popular again is actually GIMP. Believe it or not, the girls like to make little bracelets and little necklaces out of it. So we have GIMP in a couple of different colors and whatnot. Another thing that's popular that we like to do is we like to actually make our own kits right here at the store. So the girls can actually take it, bring it home. All they need to do is add glue, and then they can go ahead and have some fun.
Credit card, a greeting card kit?
This is actually a wreath kit. It actually shows you, it's a whole hand, and they cut it right out, and then they actually have an entire wreath all made, right. So it's really cute. So we actually have some stamps in this department, some bottle cap jewelry, and a whole bunch of other types of little things that kids can come in and say, oh, you know, I'd really love to make this donut bracelet and earring set today. So a lot of times they do require parental supervision, but they are something simple and easy for those rainy days to make. We do have a lot of kids classes that we do. We do one typically once a month. This is just an example of some Father's Day cards that we had done, or dad's cards. And these are just some samples of what they can do. We've done some Girl Scout and birthday parties here before as well. We've made jewelry boxes, and we've made some duct tape purses and some other things as well for those type of events. We've done Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts, or Cub Scouts, sorry, and Girl Scouts. We've done some painting, some more stamping, other different types. And again, it's to what your child can do. Our classes are typically aimed for kids ages 6 to 12. So it's a huge array of whether or not they can actually have more fine motor skills or less. So we try to give it a broad example, but for groups we can actually go much more specific and do something similar to a jewelry box.
Okay, why don't we move back over here to this next section, and
sure.
What have we got here?
So this begins our die wall. This is all different types of what they call steel dies. You can see some of them have fairly pretty packaging with different colors on them. And then some of them have a lot to the imagination. but that's exactly what we're all about. We're all about giving you some inspiration and inspiring your imagination.
And what these do is they cut the shapes in the paper.
They do cut the shapes in the paper. This one here is actually the mustache die, and I have that mustache die right here. And you'll see that it comes with four different dies here. And what one of my instructors has done with this is she's taken the two smaller ones here, she's turned them upside down and made a tulip out of it. Isn't that neat? So
that's creative.
That is creative. And that's what we like to do here. We do a lot of different creative things like that. We also do just some very typical. You can see in the background, we've used just some mirror paper here. And we've just taken a die cut and actually, You can see we've taken a die cut and just added some little embellishment to the back of just some ornament pieces here. So it's just a couple of different ways to use them. You don't have to go out of the box, or you can stay in the box.
Good. Well, let's wander off to the next section then. What have we got here now, Kim?
This is the latest, most popular trend in art journaling and mixed media. This is the jelly printing plate. Now, most of the time, a jelly printing plate was made out of actual gelatin.
Anything like the old mimeographs when we were in school?
Well, sort of, kind of like that. But this time, when you make it, you really make one or two, and then you start over again. Mm-hmm. It's easy, cleans up with soap and water. You don't really need a whole lot of anything except cheap acrylic paint. You do need a little brayer. Sometimes you might want a stencil or whatnot, but this particular tool you'll have forever and ever. And it makes really great samples of papers and different backgrounds for your art journals. We have a guest instructor coming in, and she comes in to the store often. She's from Topsom, Maine. And she makes beautiful pieces from that gelatin plate, just like these here.
Okay, let's see another one.
I'll give you another one.
There's a lot, it looks like a lot of work going into all of that.
It's actually a lot of fun work.
Well, that's even better.
You want to be creative, but at the same time, you want to have something substantial to show for it at the end of the day, so. You can just see some of the beautiful.
Now, there's some of that grunge work you were talking about.
Yes,
earlier.
Yep, has a little bit of some color there, but at the same time, some beautiful crisp lines and some space for your actual own handwritten journaling, too. Mm-hmm. And you can see she's just chosen some colors and gone with the theme. And all of these were made with that jelly plate. How simple, how easy. Yeah. Really a very versatile tool. Look at here, she's even used some string. So she's just put some string down on top of it, put this piece of paper on top of the string, and created this beautiful design. So it's actually a really great
That looks
thing
like
to
some
have.
Of my hand-drawn roadmaps.
This is actually just a leaf from her own garden at home, and she's used that as the image to transfer onto that. Mm-hmm. So that she's just made some beautiful, beautiful pieces of art that she can continue to embellish for years to come.
All kinds of different styles in there too.
Absolutely. And Catherine is very popular here. We love Catherine, and she's created her own stamps, and so we carry all of those. Just something to embellish your art with.
Okay.
Something to enjoy.
Now, our next section is
this is our adhesive section. Every crafting store needs to have an adhesive section.
Well, where would the world be without glue?
That's right. We have all sorts of different types of glue. We have dry glue, we have wet glue, we have immediate glue, we have glue that takes a long time to dry. We have everything that you need in the glue area. You can go ahead and just use itty bitty little glues if you want. This particular glue, it's non-refillable. It grows on the back of paper, adheres paper to paper together, and it's really a great different type of glue to use, and it travels easy. Then we have something even more, so for instance, like this Yes paste here, and this takes at least 24 hours to dry.
It's not like the old school paste that kids ate.
No, you don't want to eat this.
Oh, that's good.
But it is acid-free, it probably won't hurt you, but I don't know.
Don't think it'll taste too good?
Yeah. No, probably not. So this is just a great adhesive to make dimensional items. So if you want a lot of lift, perfect. Because this stuff here, you could make it this tall, and it's still gonna dry that tall. So we've got all sorts of different types of paste. We even have paste from Italy, adhesive from Italy. This is Cocaino glue. Actually smells like almonds.
Is this how you hold your pasta together?
No, but you can hold paper together. It actually will hold metal embellishments, buttons on, everything. But the the part that everybody loves is that it smells like almonds. So, but we have all different types of different glues, adhesives, and whatever you need to adhere your paper, your metal, your buttons, or whatever on. Ribbon.
We have some samples over here.
We do have some samples of this is just some ways that the teacher, one of our instructors, have made this beautiful card here. Let's put it together. Just like so. And when it comes out of your card, it actually will pop up. So you put it in your card just like this, into your envelope, just like this. Mm-hmm. And when it comes out, it will actually pop up. And she, of course, used all the adhesives or different types of adhesives to adhere that all together. Yep. And it just pops right open when you bring it out of your envelope. We've even got a little box here that one of our instructors has made. And you can see, this is a perfect box. Inside, you could put a couple of other greeting cards. Kind of make a little gift, a holiday gift, or something, a birthday gift or whatnot for somebody.
Little keepsakes.
Exactly, anything like that. All made out of paper, die cuts, adhesive, and something easy and simple to make for somebody.
Okay, moving back a little bit more, we have some other stuff here too.
We have a small variety of different types of jewelry making supplies. We've actually had people come in off the street and needed some just O-rings and jump rings fixed, and we can do that pretty easy, typically just in a few moments even.
Mm-hmm.
We've actually have an instructor that has done what they call a Byzantine bracelet. I don't know how the best way to hold that. See that? And that is just... It's just a bunch of O-rings put together, and just, it's called the Byzantine bracelet, but it's just a really beautiful bracelet to have on.
Like chainmail.
It is exactly like chainmail. So she's done some things like that before, and we've also had her do something with this another newer product called ice resin. Now, ice resin's been around for a while, actually, but it's just come re-popular again. And here, in this particular piece, what she's done is she's embedded some gear pieces, and that's very popular right now if you've heard of steampunk.
Oh, yes.
Yep. So this would be like her version of a steampunk necklace. A little bit of gears put together, and you can see the different images.
That's something that would go
right
over
there.
Big at the science fiction convention.
Yes, exactly. Yep. So we like that.
Okay, well, I guess it's time to move on to the next section.
Sure.
This is a very interesting section of the store, Kim. What goes on here?
This is our seasonal section of the store, and this moves out as the seasons come along. So right now we just happen to have some Halloween, but this would be Christmas, it would be Hanukkah, it would be Valentine's, it would be Easter, and this is just an array of different things specific to those holidays.
So you have the dies and the stamps. And
we do exactly that. We have lots of different types of stamps. We have lots of different embellishments. This is a really fun embellishment here. Right now it's just some wishbones. So very apropos to the area and the time right now. Easy to add to your pages or to your cards.
Okay, and we have specialized paper here. I saw a whole rack of this.
We do. We actually have a lot of different paper here in the store, and this just happens to be what we have in right now for Halloween. And the great thing about most of the paper, I would say 95% of this paper in the store, the best thing about it, it's double-sided. So if you like one side, you might also like the other side. Or maybe you like the other side, and you can, so it's double duty, versatile. And the great thing is sometimes is you get something that has something very specific on one side, but a little less specific on the other for a different occasion.
We have a little sample card over there. You want to hold that up?
We do. We have a sample board, and this board here was actually made by the company. This is made by Stampendous. This is a great way to show you just a little bit of inspiration and a little bit of what to do with some of the stamps. That's a lot of what people ask all the time. What can I do with this? How do I use this? And I'm always happy to show them and always happy to help. And this is just a little bit of an inspiration board in case I'm busy with another customer, or maybe sometimes they're, you know, not quite sure who to ask or what to ask. They're not sure what to do. So this is a great way to just show them what they can do with some of the stamps.
We have one more little surprise left for you, so stay tuned.
Every day, kids witness bullying.
Poor you.
They want to help, but don't know how. Teach your kids how to be more than a bystander. Visit stopbullying.gov.
One more little thing before we go. We're going to give you a little demonstration on how to do something really crafty. Kim, go ahead.
Today I'm going to show you how to do heat embossing. Heat embossing is this shiny part in the background here of this particular card. It is just a way of taking a color and adding just a little bit of texture from a stamp to your card or your project. So it's really simple and easy. Here I have already done one for you, and I'm going to just show you with that same exact stamp. This is just a stamp here that we have. Any stamp will work for this technique. And you're going to also need a watermark stamp pad or another pigment ink pad. And you're also going to need some embossing powder. This one happens to be super fine detail in black, but there's a ton of different colors, different textures, and we have a lot of different variety here at the store, so you can use any of them. One other thing you're going to need is your heat gun, and any type of heat gun will work. This one just happens to be one that's quick and easy, and I've had it for years, and it's kind of a trusty one for me, so I keep it around, keep it close. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to take my stamp and my ink pad, and I'm going to ink up my stamp. Simple and easy. I'm going to take that and I'm going to stamp that right onto my paper and give it a nice little press. You want to make sure that you have even pressure when you're stamping, and that way you'll have a perfect image. Now this is a watermark, so you cannot see it, or you should be very faint to see it.
I thought I was going to have to get out my glasses there for a second.
Yeah, it's very faint, but watch this. I'm going to just take a piece of paper. This is just computer paper that I have. Put it underneath. Unscrew my detail black, add that right on. The extra little paper chips, free of charge. Tap that right off, and you can see it's stuck right to where I have stamped it. Now what I'm going to do is heat it. And if we can get a close-up, you'll see the magic happen. So you just put this right onto it, and I like to leave it at about 3 to 4 inches above it, and I like to leave it in one spot until I see it start to melt. And you'll see it start to melt as well. And once it does, you just move it along. There it is right there. See the magic? You just move it along, and it's pretty quick once it starts to go. Finish that up all the way down. Now, don't want to touch where it's been heated right away. These heat guns do get up to about 265 degrees, so they're a lot stronger than a regular hair dryer. There you go. And here it is. You have completed just a little bit of heat embossing. Simple and easy.
Well, that's all for this episode of Keep Creating. In future episodes, we'll be showing you new techniques in crafting and previewing some of the classes that go on here at Kept Creations. Remember, this is your show. We want to know what you want to learn. If you have a special technique or want to see more inspiration, let us know. Contact Kim at keptcreations@gmail.com. Remember, the goal of this program is to make you a better crafter. We'll see you next time on Keep Creating.